Thank you, Benedita. I'm going to speak about the role, important role of anthropologists. I'm not anthropologist, but during the epidemic, I worked very closely with the anthropologists. Very large outbreak in Ebola in West Africa. And the country of Guinea is characterized by strong resistance from communities against recommendation of health and administrative authorities. And this has impacted very negatively in the fight against the epidemic, and anthropologists have been strongly requested and used in the operational field. The objective are to first explain and the genesis and the negative impact of community resistances, to explain the role of anthropologists, to share with you one concrete example from the field, and finally to give recommendation from lesson learned. The genesis of negative impact of resistances. First, basis of the fight against the transmission of the disease are early detection, isolation and management of cases, active monitoring of all contacts. Unfortunately, these activities require a close collaboration with the whole community, with social, cultural practices and beliefs very far from health recommendation. We are going to see the social, cultural practices and habits. The community used to have a close management of patients and the corpse through extended family and neighborhood with very frequent contacts. The beliefs are numerous, and we have many myths about Ebola disease. For example, in the beginning of the outbreak in the forest area, people used to say the virus come from the Western countries and that they come to kill population, Guinean population. We have also great frequency of social conflict in the country, ethnical, political, religious, and all these characteristic influence in behaviors. We have also influence of traditional healers. The traditional healers, obviously, we had many infected in the traditional healers. All these practices are obviously negative consequences. And these consequences first are community resistances to recommendation from the health system exhibited by lack of attendance of two health facility, lack of report of cases. The cases are hidden by community. And we had many demonstration and vandalism action toward official teams fighting the epidemic through the material and equipment devastation and especially physical violence up to assassination. Two doctors were killed in Guinea during this period. And the big consequence is the failure of the fight against infection transmission and spread of the epidemic around the country and beyond. What is the contribution of anthropologists? The objective is to find explanation for community behaviors and to allow the necessary changes for an acceptable behavior according to technical recommendation to control the epidemic. The strategy of anthropologists is multimodal, and based on a good knowledge of local history and customs, a judicious choice of targeted people as entry point. Usually they target the key opinion leaders. Social observation of social practices and talk with the communities through the key opinion leaders. And then analysis of social behaviours taking into account all the social determinants. These social determinants are very numerous in Guinea. I talked about ethnic, religious, political, and etc. The results expected are, under the aegis of the anthropologists, a compromise is found between the population and the health system. So the recommendations made in the context of the epidemic are followed while ensuring compliance with local sociocultural practices. In particular, all practices regarding the management of patients and bodies after the death of patients must be known and accepted by both parties. Now I'm going to give you a concrete example from the field. The context was in March, April 2014, in the beginning of the outbreak. I was part of the first group of experts just after the official declaration of the epidemic. The compound of the group was classical with epidemiologist, clinician, but with obviously an anthropologist. He was a French one working from CNRS in France. In this time, MSF had just installed ETU, and the mortality in the beginning of the epidemic was close to 100% of hospitalized patients. And very quickly, rumors of MSF killing patients circulated in Gekedu. And when population decided to organize a demonstration directed against MSF, that was the context. In this context, the response team, under the support of local authorities, the prefect of the district, undertake many activities. First, organizing by the prefect a great meeting of information and sensitization of the population on the epidemic of EVD. After the meeting of information and sensitization, followed anthropological activities in collaboration with the health staff, a visit for key persons, the opinion leaders, public open talks with communities, use of pictures, film, and documentaries about Ebola. The ETU of MSF was filmed by the anthropologist to show the openness of the activities inside the ETU. And main practical proposal was the involvement of families and in management of patients and funeral while complying with basic precaution, hand hygiene, use of gloves, disinfection of surfaces, and etc. The result, the demonstration was canceled. The collaboration started between communities and the health staff, leading to better effectiveness of the fight against the transmission of the disease, involvement of families in cases, and contact management, contact tracing and management, technical support for the funeral, and etc. And it was a designation and use of community release as human resource for information and sensitization of the community. Some illustration showing the activities. Here you can see the official information and sensitization meeting directed by the prefect of the district, but attending the national director of hygiene, and local over local authorities and all the population, women, young people, old people, etc. After these first activities, anthropologist activities with many public meetings. The illustration are from the anthropologist, but he is not here. The communities and families involvement. You see in the UTU, the presence, active presence of families. And community relays used for the funeral with the team of the Red Cross. In conclusion, the role of anthropologists is very crucial and very important, and the link with the health system. But unfortunately, it's a problem of behavior change, and there are many difficulties to get quick and definite result. And currently, there are still currently some community resistance in the country now. There is a need to capitalize for the future. The numerous lessons learned in terms of good practices in collaboration with communities for the management of cases, for contact tracing, and for funeral. Thank you very much.